More than just a lovely face to admire at night, the moon has many more uses. It influences our planet's axis tilt and the movement of the atmosphere, climate, and ocean currents, and tides. So what would happen if Earth suddenly vanished without a trace? What about us? Would we make it through? Keep watching to find out by doing so. According to Matthew Siegler, a lunar research scientist at the Planetary Science Institute in Dallas, Texas, a lot of things would have altered fairly radically 3 billion years ago when the moon was closer to the Earth. The moon is currently sufficiently far away from us for most of what it does to benefit us to be very long term, such as maintaining our orbit over tens of thousands of years. The moon, the closest object to our planet, can appear to be Earth's younger sibling. Since its creation, the spacecraft was just laying around and engaged in a gravitational tug of war. However, what if the moon disappeared tomorrow? We will look at what would happen if our moon disappeared. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more stuff before we continue. Click the bell icon to sign up for new video alerts. Have you already executed it? Let's move on. About the moon. The moon is the sole natural satellite of Earth, with a diameter roughly 1/4 that of Earth. It's the fifth biggest satellite in the solar system and the largest and most massive about its parent planet, comparable to the width of Australia. The moon is larger than any known dwarf planets of the solar system and is a planetary mass object with a distinct rocky body, making it a satellite planet according to geophysical definitions of the term. There is not much of an atmosphere, hydrosphere, or magnetic field. With a surface gravity of 0.1654 grams, it has a gravity of around 1/6 that of Earth. Jupiter's moon, Io, is the only satellite in the solar system known to have a higher gravity and density. Its gravitational impact slowly lengthens Earth's day and is the primary cause of Earth's tides. It orbits Earth at an average distance of 384,400 kilometers, 238,900 miles, or nearly 30 times Earth's diameter. The sidereal duration of the moon's orbit around Earth is 27.3 days. Lunar phases, which serve as the foundation for the months of a lunar calendar, are created when the amount of visible surface illuminated by the sun varies over each synodic period of 29.5 days from 0 to 100%. The length of a full revolution of the moon on its axis causes its same side, the near side, to face Earth constantly, and the somewhat longer lunar day is the same as the synodic period since the moon is tidally locked to Earth. However, due to changes in perspective brought on by libration, 59% of the entire lunar surface is visible from Earth. The moon is believed to have formed 4.51 billion years ago, not long after Earth, from the debris of a massive collision between the planet and a hypothetical Mars-sized body called Theia, according to the most widely accepted origin theory. After that, due to tidal contact with the Earth, it retreated into a larger orbit. Dark volcanic maria, sometimes known as seas, are present on the moon's near side and cover the voids between bright, old crustal highlands and large impact craters. By the conclusion of the Imbrian epoch, some 3 billion years ago, the majority of the big impact basins and mare surfaces were present. The reflectance of the lunar surface is somewhat brighter than that of a weathered asphalt, making it non-reflective. The full moon, on the other hand, is the brightest celestial body in the night sky due to its huge angular diameter. Due to their nearly identical apparent sizes, the moon can fully block out the sun during a total solar eclipse. The prominence of the moon in the Earth's night sky and its predictable cycle of phases have served as cultural touchstones and influences for human communities throughout time. Language, calendars, art, and mythology all exhibit these influences. The Soviet Union's Luna 2 uncrewed spacecraft was the first artificial object to orbit the moon in 1959. Luna 9 made the first successful soft landing on the moon in 1966. The Apollo program of the United States, which put 12 men on the moon's surface between 1969 and 1972, has been the only one to send humans there. A thorough geological understanding of the moon's origins, interior structure, and subsequent history has been developed using the lunar rocks that these and other uncrewed missions returned. What would happen to the Earth if the moon disappeared? Our moon is in motion. It wanders away from the Earth by around 1.5 inches every year. Additionally, the Earth's rotation is slowing down in this process. What if the moon just vanished one night? Were we to miss it? A full moon is typically 14,000 times brighter than Venus, the next brightest object in the sky. Therefore, if it were not there, every night would be as dark as the new moon. Additionally, stargazing would be amazing. However, you would start to understand how crucial the moon is to live on Earth by morning. To begin with, the moon has the brightest impact on Earth's tides compared to the sun, Earth's rotation, and the sun. How would the oceans react if the moon vanished? The tides in the Earth's oceans would be around one-third the size they are now. Oceanic material is stirred up by tides, allowing coastal organisms to flourish. Crabs, mussels, starfish, and snails are a few animals that depend on tides to survive in these ecosystems. Without a coastal environment, this might impact other land and marine organisms and cause mass extinctions. Tidal motions also stabilize the Earth's climate. The tides, which disperse warmer water worldwide and affect the climate globally, propel ocean currents. On Earth, temperatures might be more extreme if this influence did not exist. If the moon disappeared, what would happen to the animals? Animals worldwide might become very confused if the moon were to disappear. Predators must hunt in complete darkness at night and with only a hint of moonlight. Without any nighttime lighting, prey would flourish since predators find them more difficult to spot. Similar to how tides affect the environment, this could significantly impact the ecosystem and potentially result in the extinction of some predatory animals. How would the seasons change if the moon vanished? Finally, if the moon disappeared, the Earth's seasons might shift significantly. Because of the tilt of the Earth, we experience four distinct seasons: spring, summer, autumn, and winter. Earth tilts around 23.5 degrees concerning the plane in which we orbit the Sun. Our planet is held in place by the gravitational attraction of the Moon. The tilt of the Earth might vary widely if the Moon were not there to stabilize it. From having no tilt, which indicates no seasons, to having a significant tilt, which means extreme weather and even ice ages. Could the Moon ever disappear? Is a world without moons genuinely a possibility, or are all of these speculative scenarios just ongoing throughout experiments? The moon sat significantly closer to Earth when it formed from the fragments left over from proto-collision Earth with a planet the size of Mars. Earlier, the moon may have orbited the planet at a distance of only 22,500 kilometers, 14,000 miles, as opposed to the current distance of 402,336 kilometers, 250,000 miles. Looking up into the night sky millions of years ago, you would have seen a massive moon up to 20 times bigger than it's today. Earth's tides caused the moon's gradual separation from the planet, which is now occurring at a pace of 3.78 centimeters, 1.5 inches, every year. The moon is slightly in front of the tidal bulge due to the planet's rotation, which supplies the moon with a tiny amount of energy that causes it to move into a higher orbit. Therefore, the Earth's rotation is slowed down, and the Moon expands its orbit due to the tidal interactions between the Earth and the Moon. Both effects balance out to conserve angular momentum. The Moon will continue to migrate away, and the Earth's days will eventually lengthen by a second every 50,000 years, but this will not last forever. The Moon's orbit is predicted to reach its greatest reach at some time in the future, 50 billion years from now, according to a prediction from the Planetary Science Institute. One side of the Earth will always be facing the Moon at that time, just as it does now, because the Moon's orbit will take 47 days to complete, and Earth's rotation period will also be 47 days. A 47-day, if that makes sense. When the system is in sync, there are no tidal effects between Earth and the Moon. The only place humans have ventured beyond Earth is on the Moon. The moon, the largest and brightest object in our sky, stabilizes the Earth's axial wobble, which results in a generally consistent climate. This makes Earth a more livable planet. Additionally, it brings about tides which produce a rhythm that has aided humans for countless years. A body the size of Mars likely collided with Earth and created the Moon. The Moon on Earth is the fifth largest of more than 200 moons that orbit planets in our solar system. Because no one was aware that there were any other moons until Galileo Galilei discovered four moons orbiting Jupiter in 1610, Earth's lone natural satellite is simply referred to as the Moon. The Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, the twin Artemis spacecraft, and the upcoming Artemis program to return astronauts to the Moon are the three robotic spacecraft that NASA is currently using to explore the Moon. Today's video has come to an end. If you liked this video, subscribe to the channel and give it a thumbs up. Remember to click the bell icon to get alerts when new videos are posted. I will see you in the upcoming video. Bye for now.